The mayor of London, Ontario, says he is innocent and he is rebuffing calls for him to resign over fraud charges. Joe Fontana is accused of misspending taxpayers' money on his son's wedding when he was a federal Liberal MP. As Mike Lecouture reports, Fontana is now fighting to clear his name.
Wading through the throng of media, Joe Fontana remains defiant. He's not stepping down as London's mayor, despite facing charges of defrauding the public purse.
I'm innocent. I'm innocent, and I've been given a mandate by the people of London to discharge my obligations and responsibilities.
Fontana was given those responsibilities after winning the 2010 mayoralty race with less than 50% of the popular vote, and those who oppose him are growing in numbers.
Joe Fontana's got to go!
Many Londoners want him to quit, or at least step aside while the case is before the courts.
We should not have to put up with corrupt politicians running our city. London deserves better than this.
Now, Brian Gibson even started an online petition calling for Fontana to step down. So far, he has more than 1,000 signatures.
Citizen of London, I don't think that he should still be leading our city. And I hope that he will reconsider and that there'll be enough public pressure that he will reconsider.
Well, Fontana is just the latest Canadian mayor facing accusations of wrongdoing. Laval and Montreal's mayors haven't been charged, but both stepped down after being named at Quebec's corruption inquiry. Unlike those mayors, Fontana says he has the public's confidence.
Well, I can lead, and that was their choice. That's not my choice.
Now, Fontana faces three charges, including fraud, for allegedly using taxpayer money to pay for his son's 2005 wedding at this banquet hall. He was a Liberal cabinet minister at the time. Original reports claim $20,000 was paid using Public Works Canada checks, but the charges are for just a $1,700 deposit.
There were a number of deposits, my understanding, made that year for a room for various other events as well.
Fontana's first court date is January the 8th, but his lawyer expects the trial will take at least a year. Mike Lecouture, Global News, Ottawa.